Hey everyone, Vinayak here. I have reviewed Sonoff devices earlier, like the Sonoff Smart Switch, which allows controlling existing lights using Wi-Fi. And I noticed that Sonoff has a line of Zigbee devices too, and I'm quite surprised at how small they are. Let's check them out in this video. I have here a bunch of Sonoff devices. These use Zigbee, which is a low-cost, low-power, wireless mesh network standard targeted at battery-powered devices in wireless control and monitoring applications. Let's check out what all I have. Here is a micro USB power adapter. Zigbee devices are battery-powered, but they cannot communicate with your phone or Wi-Fi devices directly. So they need a hub, which acts as a mediator. So this powers the hub. Here is the Zigbee hub. This is the central communication point between the Zigbee devices and your Wi-Fi. Any Wi-Fi device control is routed through this hub. This hub works with the Zigbee door sensor, temperature sensor, motion sensor, and more. The hub can also control Wi-Fi devices like the Sonoff switch I have installed earlier. The interoperability is possible through the EV-Link app we install on our phones. Opening up the box, we have a manual and the hub itself. I'm quite surprised how small it is, but this small size makes it more portable and concealable. The manual has instructions in multiple languages, and this actually makes it more complex to read through. Here's the hub, minimal other than the Sonoff logo on the top and the two LEDs. On the side, we have a micro USB power port and a small reset hole right next to it. Now for the sensors that would link to the hub. First off, I have the motion sensor. This would detect motion using the PIR sensor and send a notification to your phone. This information can be used to trigger any other smart devices, not only Zigbee but Wi-Fi too. So you could have the lights turn on in your living room as soon as you walk in. It has a 6-meter detection distance and 110-degree viewing angle. Quite a handy smart device for placing anywhere in your home to detect motion and trigger alarms. You can stick it anywhere using the provided 3M double-sided tape. Here's the door sensor. Basically, this device would alert us if a door is opened or closed. Say you have your door open, you could turn off your air conditioner or turn on an air purifier. You can use it for security purposes to be alerted when you're not home and someone has opened the door. It has two pieces. When together, the sensor would send a closed signal and if apart, would send an open signal. These have 3M double-sided tapes also provided to mount the device. And lastly, we have the Wi-Fi switch. This switch allows remotely controlling any Wi-Fi Zigbee device. It can be placed anywhere or even mounted using 3M tape. We have three modes. One is single click, another is double click, and lastly we have a long press. We can program the switch to respond accordingly. All these sensors and even the hub are made out of polycarbonate. We need to get these devices ready for pairing. So for the Wi-Fi switch, you need to open up the backplate and it uses a CR2450 coin cell. Notice that the cell has a plastic sheet below. Just pull it out and the device is now powered on. The same for the other devices. I just wish they made it simpler to open. Worried when the time comes to change the batteries while mounted, would it still be easy? All three devices are ready. Now to set up the hub. We use the EV-Link app to set up the hub and the connecting devices. So install, register for an account, using the micro USB adapter provided, we power on the hub. On first boot, the hub is in the pairing mode, which would be active for 3 minutes. As it took me longer than 3 minutes to start the pairing, I needed to use a small pin to reset the device using the hole on the side. The device is found and now we need to add other Zigbee devices as sub-devices. The Wi-Fi switch needs to have the backplate removed to reset the device for pairing. This is slightly annoying, but that's done now. Add device and it's found. Simple. You can see a history log of when and how many times the switch was clicked. The motion sensor is relatively easier to reset. Using a mobile SIM tool, just poke in and you can see the red light blink indicating it's reset. Add the device to the app and it's set up. Similarly, the door sensor also has the reset button or the reset hole on the side. So reset it, add the device and it's done. Now all the devices are available on the EV-Link app. If you activate the EV-Link skill on your Alexa app, you can control these devices via voice Or you can also trigger routines to run if any of the sensors are triggered. These sensors are now found in the Alexa app. I have set my door sensor as a hindrance to my snacking. So when I open the cupboard, a message is transmitted to all my Echo devices in the house.
Please close the cupboard.
Motion sensor, I've used it in the living room to turn on the lights as soon as I walk in. The wireless switch is used to turn off the lights in my son's room, who always tends to keep them on. So wherever I am, I can just single tap to switch off, double tap to switch on. These are just some simple use cases. I'm only worried about how long the batteries will last. These CR2450 cells are available on Amazon but seem to be selling at a premium price. Zigbee devices are supposed to be power efficient, so it could last long. Prying open the back is a bit of a hassle and I'm worried I might break it, making the device useless. I already have a few dents on it. And now for the performance, the sensors worked well, even with my Echo devices, which allowed running routines with non-Sonoff smart devices, which is a big plus. We do have Google and IFTTT support, if that's how you roll. So do you guys want more information on the sensors? Just comment below and I will try to answer the questions and maybe make even another video on what you want. So that's the end of this video. Make sure to like, subscribe and also hit the notification bell to be notified when new videos are added. Thank you for watching and see you all next time.